to boldface this movement's serialization of the Federal Ministry of Power, Works and Housing. Today, our lens will zoom into the work sector as we dissect its activities and achievements under the leadership of His Excellency Babatunde Raji Fashola, SAN, right here on Boldfaces. The Ministry of Works is responsible for civil works, especially the construction of roads, bridges, buildings, and other civil engineering undertakings. Presently, the federal government is executing so many road projects, and construction workers are engaged on these sites nationwide. My name is Trisha Etsegbe-Kerry. You stick around after the break as we continue our focus on the construction and rehabilitation of federal roads and bridges right here on Boldfaces.
On the 10th day of November 2015, President Muhammadu Buhari announced the measure of the Federal Ministry of Power, Works and Housing and the Honorable Minister of Power, Works and Housing, Mr. Babatunde Raji Fashola, SAN, set out the agenda for delivering change in the public works relating to roads and bridges. The ministry has constructed multiple roads and bridges, in the process recovered thousands of jobs that were lost during the past administration.
There's a lot going on the road network. We are constructing roads in every state of this country, and I say that matter of factly.
We actually have 365 roads under road contracts, and 244 of them we inherited. They were awarded between 2001, and they were not completed when we came in 2015.
When we came on board in 2015, the president was very, very clear that all ongoing projects must be completed. The monies that were given to start these projects belong to Nigerians, and you have to continue to deliver on the infrastructure.
A nation cannot grow without, you know, equal development in the areas of our infrastructure. But only 20 billion naira was allocated in 2015. But in 2016, the government of President Muhammadu Buhari allocated over 200 and something billion. And consider the fact that immediately after 2015, in 2016, we went into recession. And even in the middle of that, that huge, you know, sum was allocated for works.
But the critical infrastructure today is the road, which carries goods, services, and people from one end of Nigeria to the other. Yes, if you are at the port area, you need a transportation to take you to the hinterland. That is what the roads are doing. So, this administration identified critical routes in this country. There are critical routes that are the artery of survival of Nigerians.
Why is infrastructure important? Let me say to you that for over a century, all of the nations that we want to look like, right, have first invested in infrastructure. The city of London was essentially rebuilt after the Great Fire. So we don't want to burn down Nigeria in order to rebuild it. After the global depression of the World Series crash in 1920, America rebuilt from there under a plan called the New Deal. In many respects, not too dissimilar from what the Economic Recovery and Growth Plan is. Invest in infrastructure. That's when all of the highways there. So if you like those countries, it can happen here. That's what we want to do.
President Muhammadu Buhari job recovery is the result of an expansive infrastructure spending that saw WOCS budget grow from 18,132,000,000 in 2015 to 394,000,000 in 2018.
Every Nigerian will attest to the fact that the road infrastructure has developed highly within the last 3 years from what it used to be. Comparing this present regime to the last administration, this present government has pumped in so much money into development of road infrastructure, and it's evident across the country. As I talk to you, there's no state in the entire country that we are not working and we are fixing roads.
You see, there is a nexus, you know, between infrastructural development and economic growth. Whenever you have massive infrastructural growth, it always has a corollary of having, you know, having a direct impact on the economy. Because when you build roads and build bridges, people are employed to actually do the work. You have engineers, you have those in the middle cater, you have artisans. Then you even have suppliers who supply food and all those things in construction sites. So whenever there is infrastructural development, when money flows into those structures, it has a direct impact on employment of people. And you know, when people are employed, they have more income, when their spending power improves, and when they spend, it boosts the economy.
Today, there is no state across the country where the federal government is not executing at least one road project and construction workers are engaged on these sites. Sections of the Ilorin-Jeba, Sokoto to Jega, Sokoto Ilela has been completed. While WOCS is progressing nationwide from Jadar to Mayobewa, Enugu to Port Harcourt, Lagos to Ota, Ikorodu to Sagamu, Benin to Okene, Lokoja to Abuja, Kano to Maiduguri, Abuja to Kaduna, Kano and many others nationwide.
So the argument that we are slow, for example, it's not meritorious. Our results are quicker over a shorter time, and we have done more with less. And we are employing people, and those are the people who you have to persuade that you want to change them with a team that did not pay them for 5 years. It's going to be a hard sell. It's going to be a hard economic sell. For me, as a road worker, as a construction company, to prefer an employer that did not pay me for 5 years to an employer that is paying me every 3 months, it's a hard economic sell.
So, attached to every road project, there are collateral benefits that will come. And that was exactly what the president saw and said, remobilize these people to go back to site so that we can employ these numbers of people that you are saying.
You have people that sell food, people that sell recharge card, people that sell water and other such things, even clothing. You need to go to any of our sites on the last day of the month to see their economic activities. I think going forward, it's a real positive effort by the federal government.
So you will see the president addressing airports, new airports being opened, railway being constructed, new bridges being committed, new power plants being, that's the road to prosperity. So while some people are talking of what they want to do, President Buhari is in the midst of doing exactly what they say they want to come and do. Do you want to stop what is going on? Are you going to risk another opportunity when those who had more did less?
But most importantly, some of these contracts, like I said, were awarded by administrations before this administration. But three questions. What was the quality of the road that was being built? Second questions, were they paid Third question, what is the quality of the contractor that is being given the job to handle? These were addressed.
If I will start with the second Niger bridge, is for most people in that axis and most Nigerians, it's a dream come true. But a lot of people thought that project would never be actualized, but in this administration, a lot has been done already.
I think in a long while, we did not keep this type of statistics, but now we keep these statistics to show side by side, state by state, zone by zone, and then nationwide, all people engaged on federal highway bridges and road projects. So these numbers are the direct number of those employed. You now have those that are indirectly employed, but whose lives are impacted by those people that are employed.
When you develop your infrastructure, the economy develops because you save a lot of time and a lot of people are able to move. And when you are able to move goods and services across the nation, definitely you improve the economy.
The president, Muhammadu Buhari, was gracious enough to give us money to pay the contractors for so many reasons, to deliver the roads and to also call back employees of the construction companies that were laid off because that previous government did not pay the contractors and so they laid off their staff. They did not only lay their staffs, they were also holding monies for people that were doing subcontracting, people that were supplying them with gravel, sand and cement and some other ancillary services, diesel and so on. So by that singular act of paying the contractors, the people were re-engaged, the subcontractors were paid, and then their businesses moved in and the economy started turning around again.
Has the federal government built roads? They are also attending to old or damaged bridges and restoring the value of maintenance. Difficult or abandoned projects like the second Niger Bridge, Lagos-Ibadan Expressway, and the Bodo-Boni Bridge has been brought back to life by the President Muhammadu Buhari-led administration.
The Federal Ministry of Power, Works and Housing, under the leadership of His Excellency Babatunde Raji Fashola, SAN, made an inspection tour driving through the Apapa-Wharf Road. He also flagged off the reconstruction of the Apapa-Oshodi-Orosoke-Ojota Expressway right here in Lagos. The flagged off took off at the Euro 65 Apapa-Oshodi Expressway right here in Lagos. Don't go away, both faces will be right back.
This road and this Tinkan Island port was built between 1975 and 1978. At that time, in 1978, I was 15. Now, 40 years after, this road has not expanded. It has not been reconstructed. It has just always been patched and moved on. But it takes one man's commitment, one man's good heart, one man's goodwill and determination to make the kind of investment that is now being made here. It is President Muhammadu Buhari.
Project like Apapa Orosoke, which you know is the key road to the nation's port. It affects everybody. If you think it's only in Lagos, no, it's not only in Lagos. If it takes an importer 2 weeks to take his goods out of the ports, he's going to transfer that cost to everybody.
We must specially thank the Honorable Minister of Power, Works and Housing for pushing both himself and his staff for making sure that yes, it is done. And I know how much pressure he put on me to now come out and make sure that we flag up this road. I tried to dodge, but he grabbed my leg and said, I know you must come. So thank you very much, Honorable Minister, for making it possible. But I can assure you also, we will not, and I repeat, we will not disappoint you and Nigerians. We will make sure that we do the best job, and also to make it on time. This new concrete road, with a cost of about 73 billion, is indeed a new dam that will alleviate the sufferings of Nigeria, especially companies that have lost so much revenue as a result of the state of all this road network, which they were built over 40 years ago. I'm sure more than 60% of the people standing here were not born at that time. This road, I promise you, Honorable Minister, like what I said earlier on, will be the best. It will last over 45 years, minimum 50 years. And we will also ensure that the cost will not be inflated at all. It is a task that must be done. No stone will be left unturned to ensure that high quality job is done and delivered ahead of schedule. This will surely open up the economy, boost our ease of doing business, and also improve our ranking considerably in the annual global competitiveness report.
Let me congratulate the federal government of Nigeria for flagging off one of the most important roads in this country. This project is far, far overdue because of the four exits and the entry into the federal capital territory. This is the road that covers most states. About 16 states come in and out of Abuja through this route. And I think it's a very, very great development at this time that the federal government would flag off this road, expansion and dualization.
Road building is not just works. It is works, service, budget and planning, finance, and so many other departments who have roles to play.
So when they tell you Buhari is slow, tell them that his results are quicker. 3 years is faster than 16 years. But I think it is also important to emphasize that these roads connect FCT, Nasarawa, and Benue. So it is a road connecting people. If they had done this many, many years ago, perhaps some of the divisions would have been healed. The road to prosperity in Nigeria is roads, railway, airports, and infrastructure. So what is going to happen here from Abuja, Akwanga, Kefi, and all the way to Makurdi is jobs. Let me tell you some of the jobs. Mining, laterite, stone, granite, supply of sand, transporting them, cement, iron rod, labor, engineering work, and that's why Engineer Mokolu is here.
And it is not just roads, it is rail, also in partnership with the Chinese, from Abuja to Kaduna, from Abuja Business District to the airport, and of course, Port Harcourt International Airport. All of these have been completed in 3 years of Buhari. Tell them that Buhari's results are quicker than their results in 16 years. That is the debate we are going to have in the next election. Who has done more with less? And who you should trust with your time and with your resources?
The ministry has identified critical roads requiring intervention while construction is going on in order to move traffic and ease commuter journey time across the country. Presently, the local Owerri Bridge is nearing completion. The damaged Tatabu Bridge linking Ilorin and Jeba has been reconstructed, and the Tamborawa Bridge in Kano, the Isiagboro Bridge in Rivers, Eko Bridge in Lagos, and the old Niger Bridge that links Anambra and Delta are receiving regular maintenance attention. Road users and contractors shared their past experience before President Buhari was elected into office and expressed happiness on the level of work done and the significant progress under this present government.
Well, I think that what I get across board inspires us to continue. Road users say that their journey times are reducing on the sections we have completed, and that's what we want to hear. That's the ease of doing business. That's a globally competitive economy that President Buhari commits to. If he makes a journey
of 3 days becomes 3 hours. That's competitiveness. That's efficiency. So that's what you will see along that Alep-Ugesi road in Cross River. That road used to take 3 days to cross. Now the 60 kilometers have been completed, so it will reduce the journey time. By the time the final section is done, it's now a journey of 3 hours from 3 days. When we finish the Bodo-Boni Bridge, the local Oweto Bridge, the section from Ushegudu to Otukpo that links the bridge to Nasarawa side, a 2 day journey to the east through Makurdi will become a matter of few hours to cross to Nasarawa. The Ilorin-Jeba Road, when I went there, people were there for a week to traverse a 90 kilometer section. Now it's done. So 90 kilometers is roughly 1 hour if you are driving at an average of 100 kilometers per hour. And that's what is changing. So this is what is happening. And people who are driving on the Lagos-Ibadan Expressway, they used to sleep on that road before. Now it's not a day's journey, subject to some bad driving sometimes. It's a few hours. If there's no bad driving and people manage the congestion. And with the opening today, people will report. You go out. Their Christmas experience this year should be better than the experience last year. That's how initial works, making it better. So, and you will see the same thing across sectors. People are reporting to me, I get messages, oh, I drove from Warri to Lagos 5.5 hours. Those journeys used to take a whole day. People used to sleep on the Benin Ore Road. So that's what is changing. It's not finished, but it's improving, without a doubt in my mind. And it will get better.
There's so much we are doing presently. We are fixing all the roads. We are working around the clock. We are doing all sorts of things that have not been done in previous years. And so much money is being committed into the budget for this present administration, from this present administration on road infrastructure. It's a very huge improvement, and that's why you are seeing that there are a lot of improvements on our roads across the country.
So we are thankful for the president for determining, right from his inception of his administration, that massive infrastructural development is a sine qua non to economic growth. We thank him for that, and we thank him for bringing our country out of recession and setting us in the right course for growth. So we are quite appreciative, and we wish and hope that he will return.
If you want to build a house, there are many types of houses, but the house that President Buhari has in mind is a house that will protect all Nigerians, a house of prosperity that will withstand the vicissitudes of economic ups and downs. The economic climate around the world is not stable. Oil prices, cocoa prices, stock prices move around from time to time by global politics, by conflict, by nature, environmental hazard. If you don't build a house of resilience, anytime those things happen, as we have seen in the past, we get into trouble. One way is that how can we continue to import rice when we have land and we have rice farmers? So President Buhari says, let's plant our rice. I won't ban the importation of rice, but I will not give you cheap foreign exchange to import rice again, because you are taking money of Nigerians out. So rice importation has dropped by 90%. So go and tell the farmers who are benefiting from that you won't vote for Buhari. You will see what they will do with their own PVC. Go and tell the miners who are supplying aggregates, sand, rocks for construction company that you will vote for Buhari, because their economic life is being affected positively by his spending in infrastructure. When people say, oh, the Ministry of Works and Housing has the biggest budget, yes, it's a budget for the miners. Once we get the money, we pay the contractors, the other sand, the other granite, the other laterite, the other bitumen. That's where the money goes. Go and tell those people not to vote for Buhari. They know the difference from not being paid over 3 years to getting paid every 3 months or 6 months. The difference is clear. So they are voting for their own economic interest, and that's what democracy is about. Which government serves your interest better? Go ask the construction companies. They will tell you which government is going to serve their interest better. Their workers know that their pay has become more regular because we are paying, and we are paying regularly with less money. So go and tell those students in the universities whether they want the solar projects. And go and tell the market women, whether our market men and women in Ariaria, in Abia, in Bagi, in Sura, whether they want the electricity. Those are the reasons. Go and ask them, not me. So essentially, let me sum it up. You can't build a house without a solid foundation. The solid foundation first is stop the stealing, stop the waste. And that is why if you continue, somebody will say, well, you can't leave your shop and be chasing criminals. And the vice president rightly said, if you don't chase the criminals away, you won't have a shop left. So people cite China. What is the treatment for corruption in China? They know the importance of corruption. That's why they treat it, view it very severely. So affect all of these people, market people, traders, small businesses, children, hospitals, energy in the schools. That's where the money comes. That's where the money goes. And if you steal money, that's what you are denying. That's what Buhari is about. That's why you should vote for him.
We have the manpower. We have the will. We have the skill sets. We know what we want to deploy.
Everybody has played their part. So the team is gelling, the team is blending. And all of the officers and men who work together in the ministry, the Mustafa Baba Shehuri and Suleiman Hassan Zama, who have provided additional hands to move the pump, the permanent secretaries, the directors, the heads of parastatals, and even the junior officers. And you will see that we've focused on team building from our retreats, trying to get more people together to understand and focus on a common purpose, the mandate to serve Nigeria, to rebuild the infrastructure, to provide energy, to provide roads, to provide power. So it's teamwork.
The Honorable Minister Babatunde Rajefashola SAN stated, "We came to this job in November 2015 with a mountain to climb. With careful thinking, planning, and a dedicated team of public officers, we have a firm foothold on our way to the top. Our policies have shown what is possible with critical sectors recording growth. What remains is the time that it will take for the full harvest of the fruit of our policies in plenitude and prosperity of our people. We cannot go back to 16 years of inactivity bottom of the mountain governance when the plateau of our next level is now within reach."
Welcome back. Apart from the recovered construction jobs and growth in construction sector of the economy, under the leadership of President Muhammadu Buhari, our journey times have reduced significantly on these roads. The Honorable Minister of Power, Works and Housing, His Excellency Babatunde Rajefashola SAN, acknowledged that works has not finished on these roads. But as long as this government remains in power, they'll be able to finance more projects and take the country to the next level of development. See you next week as the Minister of Power, Works and Housing serialization continues with the Housing Ministry, right here on Bold Faces. My name is Trisha Esegbe Kerry. Stay positive. Bye-bye.